Hello everybody. During this presentation, you will learn everything you need to know about the world's most advanced AI-powered DNA ploidy test, which is now available in India. You can start using this advanced technology in your practice and provide unique and life-saving service to your patients. DNA ploidy test is developed by the world's most influential institution in cancer research and treatment, British Columbia Cancer Research, which is located in Canada. It is a quantitative diagnostic test based on aneuploidy. Some of you may be wondering what aneuploidy is. Basically, it is an abnormal cell with abnormal DNA quantity. So these abnormal cells can develop into cancer, and we really need to look out for them. The most important thing about DNA ploidy test is that it can detect abnormal cells up to 2 years before cytology or histology alone, because those early changes may not yet be visible morphologically while analyzing through the microscope. High accuracy makes it extremely valuable. The sensitivity of this test is 98% and specificity is 100%. Also, it is objective. There is no place for human error. DNA ploidy test was internationally standardized by European Society for Analytical Cellular Pathology and is certified by many authoritative institutions around the world. Now, you can access this powerful test in India and help your patients to prevent oral cancer or detect it at an early stage. It will give you the power of molecular diagnostics with highest accuracy and quantitative results. It will cause no pain to your patients. Believe me, your patients will be happy about it. And most importantly, it saves lives. You will find sample collection instructions in the kit. The sample collection is exactly the same as the brush cytology technique. The Orcellix brush has a patented design to enable optimal collection, storage, and release of cell material. Collect the sample holding the oral brush perpendicular to the site and use at least 10 rotations with scraping motion to acquire adequate sample. Do not be afraid to scrape stronger. It is not painful for patients. Now, gently push and detach the brush head into the cytology vial to select the site for sample collection. In cases where there is no visible lesion, we can brush over the most common sites for oral cancer to occur. In patients with deleterious habits and no clinically apparent lesion, take the cells from the site where the patient places the Tobacco Quid. And for lesions, we can assess the appropriate site with clinical judgment or also do the well scan examination in either of the scenarios. We can use the Wellscope VX device for advanced visualization. However, using Wellscope VX is not a prerequisite for DNA ploidy testing. DNA ploidy test can be used for screening, diagnosis, and treatment purposes. Screening. We recommend routine screening because 25% of the patients that are diagnosed with oral cancers have no risk factors. We live in places with a lot of air pollution, and hence we shall consider everyone to be at a risk of developing the disease. Regular screening for high-risk patients is important because when abnormal cells are detected early in precancerous stages, lifestyle changes or simple treatments can help to stop cancer from progressing. Relatives of oral cancer patients should be advised to undergo oral screening regularly due to genetic factors. Diagnostic. At an early stage, we may not be able to see morphological changes or any white or red patches clinically, and also morphological changes under the microscope. But DNA ploidy test helps us to assess these molecular changes as it targets aneuploidy, which is the most important and an early change that takes place in cancer. With a DNA ploidy test, we overcome limitations of human error, subjectivity, which is a major factor as the diagnosis depends on the experience and the school of thought that the pathologist has been trained with. As DNA ploidy test uses artificial intelligence, we overcome the possibility of any bias. It serves as a useful second opinion to our primary diagnosis. Also, we eliminate the possibility of wrong sampling area, low accuracy, and technical limitations. It gives us quantitative and objective information about biological cell behavior that can help us in formulating a successful treatment plan. Treatment. DNA ploidy report before the treatment sets the baseline of aneuploidy level before treatment, which is crucial to plan treatment and follow up the progress of treatment. Post-treatment, DNA ploidy test is done to confirm that there are no abnormal cells left at a treatment site that could develop into a recurrent disease. It should be done every 3 to 6 months for 3 years after surgery, and for a lifelong follow-up, which should be done annually to avoid or detect any recurrence in the early stage. On the report, we can see cell gallery. There is a chart depicting the exact number of normal, abnormal, neoplastic, cycling, and proliferating cells. There is a pictorial description of the DNA index as well. We have the diagnosis and the recommendation. How shall we interpret the results? In the DNA ploidy report, the cells that are green are normal and have a DNA index of 0 to 1.2. Those in yellow are cycling and neoplastic cells, and the DNA index is 1.2 to 2.5. The cells that are red are the abnormal cells and have a DNA index of more than 2.5. When we have a sample with more cycling and neoplastic cells, 5 to 10% or more than 10%, that means there is abnormal growth taking place, which is a matter of concern. When there are no abnormal cells, we should follow the routine screening protocol. When we see 1 to 2 cells with abnormal DNA content and or 5 to 10% cycling and proliferating cells, we shall repeat the DNA ploidy test after 3 to 6 months. This is advised because these cases require close monitoring. Also, in such cases, we should advise the patient to quit deteriorating habits. These cases show that abnormal changes have started, but with the change of lifestyle can be reversed. After 3 to 6 months, we have to repeat the DNA ploidy test to see if abnormal changes in cells are progressing or not. When we see 3 or more than 3 cells with abnormal DNA content and or more than 10% cycling and proliferating cells, we shall advise for a biopsy. When there are 3 or more cells, that means there are drastic changes that are taking place. Establishing the grade of dysplasia or cancer is necessary. The number of abnormal cells and the cycling and proliferating cells are both important considerations while stating the recommendation. When there are less than 3,000 cells in a sample, the sample is insufficient to provide a diagnosis. Hence, repeating DNA ploidy test is advised. These recommendations are based on the disease progression timeline. Following these recommendations, oral cancer can be prevented or detected early. DNA ploidy and biopsy reports supplement each other with valuable information. It is very easy to add DNA ploidy test into a workflow. In the first scenario, you see DNA ploidy test done after well scan. Well scan enhances visualization and helps us identify abnormal areas even when it is not visible in a white light. If you don't have a well scope, follow the second workflow. DNA ploidy testing helps to prevent unnecessary and painful biopsies. What are our main concerns or questions? The main comparison shall be with biopsy. Biopsy is a gold standard for diagnosis and treatment planning. Legally, it cannot be replaced by any test. The advantage of DNA ploidy is that it is very specific, objective, and a quantitative diagnostic test. DNA ploidy test is non-invasive and easy to perform. It helps to prevent unnecessary invasive procedures. Also, we can reduce needless biopsies as it gives us the exact number of abnormal cells and an idea about cellular proliferation that is taking place. DNA ploidy test can be superior to biopsy, especially in early detection of pre-cancer and cancer, because it gives us information about the DNA content of the cell. Hence, it has more precision. Another concern can be, why do we need it? Well, there is no improvement in the mortality and morbidity rates in the last 3 decades with respect to oral cancers. Early detection shall help in changing this picture. These are the references stating the accuracy and utility of DNA ploidy test. To get started, order DNA ploidy kits. In case of any questions, book a Zoom meeting with our pathologist. I'm Dr. Darshana, an oral pathologist. Thank you for your time and attention.